Hey guys, how's it going? Today I'm going to be talking about the band OOMPH. OOMPH is a really good band. It's in the style of Neue Deutsche Harte. So if you've heard of bands like Rammstein or Eisbrecher, you've probably got a good idea what kind of music these guys put out. Got some really famous songs and been running for 30 years now. Very importantly, this year here, very recently, they've released their newest album called Richter und Henker, or in English, Judge and Executioner. And at first, when I was listening to this album, just the music, I didn't notice anything off. It just sounded really good, like classic OOMPH, you know, sort of thing you'd expect. You know, the vocals were good, the instrumentation was good, everything, I would say, has led up to one of the better albums that I think OOMPH has ever put out, and that's strong in a sea of really good albums. But when I came back around to Richter und Henker, and I was watching some of the music videos that have come out with this album, I realized that something was off with the main singer. He looks a lot older and fatter than he did in 2019 when they released their last album, Ritual. And, you know, at first I thought, okay, that could just be the Rammstein effect, you know, Till Lindemann's a lot different looking than he was in his younger days. But no, this isn't the same guy at all. The lead singer's been completely replaced. He's no longer here. So where did he go? What happened? What happened to OOMPH? So immediately I started looking into this, and what I found out was that actually back in 2021, the lead singer of the band OOMPH, Dero Goi, had actually publicly left the band. The most immediate thing that you'll find among Googling this is an article from bravewords.com where you have a statement issued from the band. This is very generic, though. It doesn't really tell us about why or how he left. The other two band members, being Flux and Crap, basically just put out a statement to paraphrase saying, you know, we're very sad that the band is coming to an end in this way. We tried to do everything we can to keep it together. Just due to differences in whatever we're doing, the band is going to go on with just the two of us. Dero, our lead, is no longer going to be with us. We're going to do everything we can to find somebody new, make new music, you know, keep this going. Essentially, that we're continuing to write new songs, and that OOMPH is not dead just because of this loss. But it doesn't give us any information about why Dero left, or, you know, what reasons he would have done this. Now, you could just assume, going into this, that they've been together 30 years. You know, maybe he's just tired of performing music and not looking to it any deeper. But the deeper you go into this, you actually find a really interesting story start to emerge. One of the most helpful interviews I found in explaining the story of how the singer from OOMPH, Dero Goi, left the band was one put out by a YouTube channel called Chris Schuler. The video is titled Augen auf, Sänger von OOMPH findet zu Jesus Christus, feat Dero Goi. That basically just meaning, eyes forward, or watch this, the singer from OOMPH finds Jesus Christ, featuring Dero Goi. This is a long interview. It's about 22 minutes, 50 seconds long. It's in very dense, complicated German. I know a good deal of German, and even I have trouble following this video word for word. Doing just a very basic translation, though, and looking over some of the things that Dero Goi talks about in this video, the essential key components are that he's had a radical transformation in his life and has become a baptized or born-again Christian. From what I can tell, he's just a non-denominational, or let's call it low Protestant Christian. I'm not sure he actually attends any specific denominational church, just most definitely not Catholic or Orthodox. In the video, he talks about growing up, you know, having a lot of religious trauma and abuse from his father, growing up Catholic, and finding very strong flaws and criticisms of corrupted religious institutions, and in general, harboring a sort of doubt or anger at the concept of God. Goes through his whole music career, you know, generally in an atheist or agnostic state, trying to solve a lot of internal personal trauma and pain using different philosophical, psychological techniques. And kind of at a crisis point in his life, when his three-year-old son gets cancer. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to figure out what kind of cancer or if his son was able to survive. But when his son, you know, his very young son is extremely sick and clearly suffering and despairing, when he's dealing with the death of his father, when he's dealing with all of this internal trauma that he's never resolved, he has a radical experience of the presence of God and has sort of a newfound energy in this experience. Something transforms him and radically leads him towards, you know, the Christian religion and towards specifically, you know, what the ideas of Jesus Christ and of the New Testament and of the Holy Bible offer to him, rather than a lot of what he's been living in, kind of this rock star life his whole life. And what he kind of puts into page and paper here is that his rock star life and his new desired Christian life were just irreconcilable. He didn't believe that what he was doing with OOMPH was something that he could do in his new state. He felt that in order to embrace Christianity, he had to leave OOMPH behind. And overall, looking at everything he talks about in this interview, it's very wholesome and it seems like a genuine, good-hearted religious transformation. It seems like somebody finding a faith that gives them strength in life, which is what Christianity is all about. And honestly, I don't see anything to criticize here. I think it's a genuine personal transformation that he took on his life after 30 years of time with a band. And I don't think there's anything anyone can say to imply that's a poor decision or something that he doesn't have the right to do. But as you go online and you start to look into this matter, you also find these really heavy criticisms that he's simultaneously getting into these crazy conspiracy theories and causing all kind of controversy. So I'd like to look into that next and see to what degree that's true. So immediately just looking at Dero Goi's official channel, he's kind of got two styles of videos. The first are kind of these long talks from him on religious topics. I listened to some of this, in particular his whole thing about the biblical end times. Just even looking at this from an atheistic perspective, he's in a lot of ways just parroting ideas that are very thematically familiar with the Book of Revelation when it comes to his whole end times theory. He's very much just talking about the story of the Book of Revelation, which makes sense. For a baptized Christian, the Book of Revelation is scriptural truth. There's nothing crazy or conspiratorial for somebody to believe in the stories and the foundational scriptures of their religion. So to him, the Book of Revelation really is a revelation of God. Then you kind of have the other side of things. So you have these religious talks, which are all, you know, maybe crazy to a non-Christian, but to somebody who has any kind of understanding of Christian philosophy or just the narratives of the Bible, you know, they're very familiar ideas. They're not quite so outlandish or conspiratorial as you might think. The other side of things that he's been posting on his channel are these demo snippets of songs he's been working on. And I think the most telling of all of these, many of them are titled things like Unmasked, Brainwashed, Wolf Among Sheep. These all kind of have some odd kind of out there their titles. Something in there about, like, evil cops. He had a song called Evil Cops. I don't know, man. I've met some evil cops in my day. The one Brainwashed in particular, though, I think is kind of a symbol of maybe where I wouldn't say that he's going down the loony bin, but he's definitely saying some things that would push some people's buttons. So I definitely want to go ahead and give this one a listen for you.
When they say don't eat meat, you go vegan. When they say don't drink milk, you drink soy.
Oh boy.
When they say get the jab, get vaccinated 17. and now you don't know if you're girl or boy from soy. You got the fucking nerve to call me brainwashed.
So, I'm having a very difficult time broaching this one. Obviously, the things he's saying are extremely controversial, extremely, extremely sensitive issues, and rather than necessarily delve into those issues, I more so just wanted to gloss over the fact that here we have a man on one hand who is talking about his life's journey very seriously, very calmly, talking about finding a religion, one that's very much focused on humility and grace and generosity and peace and strength, and about how he's stepping back from this angry, demonic music that he's been using to vent his anger, but then is simultaneously still working on musical projects which are very much aggravated towards the beliefs of other people. It's almost this kind of complete 180 in that he stepped back from one kind of anger directly into another kind of anger. And it's just very strange. It's very, very odd to have a person who's saying these things on one hand and then making these musical projects that entirely contradict those beliefs on the other hand. As to what one can glean from this, I'm not sure, but it's very peculiar to observe. So I think here really lays the conclusion as to what we can glean as to what happened. You know, on one hand, you have OOMPH, who, after such a long period of time, were forced to break apart with their main lead, Dero, falling into, you know, a new radical transformation, you know, brand new religious beliefs, very strong emotional, motivational changes, and also wanting to leave to go make solo projects about being transvaxxed and evil cops. Meanwhile, OOMPH has continued on. They've found a new lead, Der Schulz, and they've made this new amazing album, Richter and Henker. And I think as time goes on, I'm curious to see where both of these things go. I'm curious to see what new projects OOMPH is able to bring to the table with their new lead, Der Schulz. I think he's extremely talented, and while he won't be able to give us the exact energy that we used to have in the old days, he's definitely going to bring something fresh and new to the table. I'm also very curious to see what transpires with Dero. I'm curious to see what the culmination of these solo music projects really is going to be. Whether or not it's going to spiral off of the rails, or whether or not he'll be able to bring it back to something coherent and entertaining. By either case, that's what happened to OOMPH.